Hi everyone, and thanks for stopping again and seeing this new week's episode about something totally amazing. Today we will try to edit a black dog in backlight condition, so very difficult, and we will face to the radial filter combined with other brushes that you will see during the editing. And it's amazing what you can achieve just in 5 minutes, just using the radial filter. So follow this lesson, this tutorial, because it's amazing. And also because I decided to edit a so difficult picture, a dog, a black dog, running in a forest during a snowfall in backlight with, oh, it was so difficult. So let's go, and thank you for subscribing if you didn't yet. Bye bye. And sorry, I forgot lip, so ooh, just for 1 second, this is lip, as you can see, and she's, oh my god. Yeah. So let's go and see you later. She's so sweet. Here we go. And today I want to edit this picture. I think it's not so easy because it's a black dog in a forest. It's a picture I took in Austria with a 300 millimeters by Nikon, and ISO 400, f2.8, 1000 in a second. I under-exposured the picture, as you can see, because I wanted to preserve totally the backlight in the background. Usually people in backlight clip the whites and the highlights. I wanted to preserve the reflection on the ground without clip it and the background. The background is made by snowflakes during the end of a snowfall, and as you can see, we have also some rays of sun in the picture that make it so difficult to work, because the rays of sun clip quite everything, especially the wet snowflakes brightened by the sun. So let's go, and how to do that in a very easy way. Let's start from the basic menu. I want to do a basic adjustment, without touching the temperature and the tint. But I want to change a bit the exposure, something like, I don't know, something like 0.60 is okay. Then I want to change the contrast, removing a bit of contrast, because I think that too much contrast sometimes reduce the visibility in a picture. But let's leave it to zero, it's not a problem in this moment. Then, about the highlights, I don't want to touch them. About the shadow, I want to preserve the dog, so I want to uprise the shadows to see the details on the dog. Then, I will change the blacks. I want the deep black on the dog, so -6, -8, something like that is okay. But I want to add vibrance on the picture. It's very important because I have many colors. I remember very colors, so I want to make it very strong. So 45, 46, something like that. And a bit also of saturation. Don't forget that the vibrance is not able to clip the colors, the saturation, yes. So don't go too much over with the saturation. Something like 15 could be enough. So, what to do? I'm figuring in my mind something orange, with an orange mood. So, how to do that? In a very easy way. Let's see, step by step, how to do it. So, the basic is okay. Now, let's go to change the tone curve a bit. So, uprising a bit the highlights, something like that. And reducing a bit the shadows, something like that. Close the tone curve, it's okay. It was just about the contrast. Let's gonna crop it a bit in this way. So, on the eyes, so eyes on the third, nothing more. It's the original picture, so quite not cropped. It's the sock of the camera, straight out of the camera. People show you the before and after so often, but they don't explain you how to do it. Today, I'm going to explain you how to do it exactly. Because it's too greenish, I want to reduce the greenish, changing the colors of the picture. So, making the color in this way, transforming the color in this way, getting the green and transform it in yellow, and getting the yellow and transform it in orange. Now, it's a look that I like more. There is also this color that I don't know what is it. Let's see if it's a kind of aqua color, probably, yes. So I want to transform it in green and the green in yellow, and reducing the saturation of that color so it's not affecting too much our picture, something like that. It's okay. Now, about the saturation of this color, I would like to use the orange a bit to make it more saturated, something stronger, you see? Not too much, but something like that is okay. And I want to add light in the orange, so I want to add a bit of light. You can transform it in this way, 25 and 26. About the yellow, it's okay. I can add a bit of luminance on the yellow too, but it's quite not visible, so no problem. And also on the greens. No, green no, about the yellow only. Something like that, and adding saturation. No, on the yellow, no, I don't want saturation to create a contrast between the yellow and the oranges. I love it very much, a lot. So, close the HSL color panel, and if you want to know how to do it and how I use it, you can check my old tutorials, and you can see exactly how to use and manage the basic panel, the HSL color panel, and the tone curve panel. First of all, there is this brush, brush on the left that I want to delete. So click this button, it's called Elim brush, it's an Elim brush, and you can change the size, the filter, that is the transition between the 0% and 100% of the adjustment, and the opacity, that is 100%. In heal, not cloning, but healing. Go here, paint it with the center exactly on the brush, something like that, and clone it from here. Okay, done. Nothing more, sorry. Nothing more. Okay. Now, we can proceed with the editing, going in the main topic of the day, so about the radial filters. So we can manage them for first in this way. Click it and you will see all the adjustments you can do as for the graduated filter that we faced the last week, and also for brushes. So you can change everything and also add a range mask. So let's start with something strong. So I want to simulate the soft light gradients of Photoshop, but it's not easy. We are in Photoshop. So first of all, click on the dog, make a big radial filter around the dog, and want to do it inside this circle. I want to do some adjustment to simulate a soft light. So adding highlights, sorry, change, invert it, because we want to affect the inside, the inner part of the radial filter. So inside, but how much? Maybe a lot, 0.096, 95 is okay. Then second thing is to add highlights. I want to make it very brighter, so something like 40. Then change the deades, because the deades will simulate enades on the picture. How much? I suggest something really strong. You can do it very strong and then you can change it. You see how much is strong? It's quite a disaster, but don't be afraid. Don't be scared about this. And let's go and let's see how to manage it, because we can remove it immediately from the dog, as we did in the last tutorial, adding a range mask. So click on about, not color, but luminance, and reduce it from the dog. So reduce the range from the blacks, here the white, and here are the blacks. So reduce it from the blacks, so that the blacks are not affected too much, as you can see. It's very, very interesting. So not too much, something like that is enough. And it's very nice, because we added the light in a backlight behind the dog. It's very, very nice. Then, because I'm not so satisfied, I add the brush inside the radial filter, I click Alt, and I remove it totally from the dog, in this way, look. Or maybe, sorry, Not totally, we can remove it just a bit, so we can leave a bit of white inside the dog. So reducing the density of our brush, the flow of our brush, that is an adjustment brush. You can see there is the minus inside the circle. So paint and remove it from the dog in this way. Tack, something like that, especially in this part, on the ears, so make it smaller a bit, so we can control it better. On the ears in this way, around the dog, and here especially. Maybe we can uprise a bit the flow, and reducing it from the back of the dog totally. Something like that. I'm very satisfied about the result. So the first radial filter is gone. Let's gonna create the second radial filter to improve the soft light more and more. So click new, and this time I want to put it in the same times but make it really, really bigger. Something like that. And want to do again, I want to add an effect of similar to before. So with a dehaze again, so a bit of dehaze. Sorry, we are affecting outside, so click invert to work inside, okay? So the dehaze, something like minus 20 or something less, minus 17 is okay, and then change the contrast, reducing a bit the contrast inside to make it more softer and softer like the gradient in Photoshop. So minus 63 is okay. And reduce it again, adjust it again, refine it again with the range mask in the luminance, removing it from the dog. So again, reduce it from the dog quite totally, as you can see. And paint inside the dog with the brush. Clicking Alt, transform it in minus, and removing it from the dog. Totally, I don't want to affect the dog. It's nice to see a part on the dog because the dog is normal. We want to have the maximum coherence between the dog and the highlights in the background. So I don't want to make the dog stick it on the picture. I want the coherence, like something like this. So a bit of light should be visible, for example, here in the shoulder. So something like that, not too much. Something like that. So we want to see some reflection on the dog, something like that. Okay, now click done. And I want to add another gradient, so the third gradient. What to do with the third gradient? I want to simulate, let me say, a vignette. But not like the vignette, I want something not symmetrical. So I put here, I create this, something like that, and I remove the exposure in the vignetting, something like minus, I think it's okay, it's a good mood. And then I will add something smaller just around the dog, so another one, on the dog only, something like that, as you can see, look, and again a vignetting around the dog. It seems really, really a lot, but it's quite necessary because we want to make it very, very special. So something like that, so we need to exaggerate a bit to understand if we are exaggerating too much or not. So a little less here, okay? Something like that is okay, maybe not so big, a bit smaller to affect more everything around the dog. And it's done. Now, we need to make the eyes brighter and to adjust some dust that I see in the picture. So click again on the dog. As you can see, it's only ISO 400, but it's totally on the left part of the Instagram, so the details are really, really poor because I wanted to preserve it to don't clip the whites in the background of the snowfall reflection by the sun. So click again and let's gonna paint this to remove it a bit from the blacks, something like that. And from here. So I think we can use this or this even better. And also about this one. And this one. And this one. And this one. I'm just adjusting a bit my dog. So it's okay. It was just something to adjust it a bit. So proceed with the eyes. So click on the brush. You can have exactly the same menu of the radial filter, the graduated filter and so on. And let's gonna adjust the eyes with a small brush. So something really smaller, something like this. And paint the iris of the dog. Okay? Something like that, irises of the dog. And what to do? As the other time. So add clarity, 100%. Add a bit of exposure, a bit of highlights, a bit of white, a bit of yellow. Something like that. I want them to be very, very bright. So I'm exaggerating. And a bit of saturation. So I want really strong, something really strong. And I want to add a bit of noise reduction on the irises. Something like that. And I will add another brush just on the pupils, something like that. And what to do? Look what we can do. We can add clarity again, adding highlights, white and exposure, something to see better the reflection. And then the last brush to use on the tip here, yes, painting. And painting. And what to do? Removing saturation in this way, adding exposure a bit and a bit of white to have nice teeth. Something like that. We are ready, so done. It's okay, we can go back. It's not finished yet, so I want to add another radial filter here on the log. So let's gonna do it in this way, rotate it a bit on over the log. And what to do? Remove saturation inside and add clarity a bit. Then another one, so another one here on the other part of the log, so something like that, bigger, something like that, and reduce again saturation inside or outside and add clarity, something like that. Now, because I love the ground, I want to add clarity here in the focus plane, something like, yes, big, something like that. And I add clarity, only clarity inside, not outside. Okay, so just inside the circle, you can see nothing. And adding means we are adding a bit of micro contrast inside the picture in this part. And it's done. Maybe a bit of exposure to make it brighter. I want to see the ray of sun in front of the log, something like that. I really love it. So, okay, done. Now, it's not ended yet. So another thing we can do is go in the detail. And I will teach you a trick to improve the sharpness of the picture that it seems not sharpened, but it is, simply because we added too many filters. So this is the trick. Amount when 150, radius, I told you to stay at 1.0, go to 3, something like that, and add details. So improve the details, we need to improve the details, and add luminance to something like 30. This is the only case where you can go so high with the amount and the radius. It's very easy. Now the dog is very, very sharpened. It's very nice. So I like the picture a lot. Now you can see the before and after. Maybe we can add a bit, and another thing, the effect. You can go in the effect and remove a bit of amount of vignetting, just to make it darken outside, something like that, not so much. Close it, and then in the basic menu, so the beginning, remove a bit of saturation to make it more natural. And for the last thing, correct the green part with a brush. It's very easy. It's gonna make it in one step, so make it bigger, not too much, something like Let me see, something like that. So I want to add the brush here, and I paint here, here, here a bit, and maybe here, 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 here. So where I see that there is a bit of green, okay? And when there is the green, I simply I adjust it, or making it warmer, or reducing saturation, or for example, you can play with the tint. In this case, I will add a bit of yellow, reducing the saturation, and adding a bit of magenta, something like that. Okay, I don't want to destroy it, but this is what we need in this part, also here, here, and here. Okay, and in this way here too, something like that. The image is finished, the post-processing is finished, and I want to show you the before and after, because it could be very, very interesting for everybody. I want to do it slowly, simply because some people asked me to do it slowly, because they didn't want to lose anything, any passage, and they wanted to see exactly the before and the after slowly. So, before, oh wow, so ugly, and after, before and after, just post-processing it with, look, wow, it's amazing, I like it a lot. I will probably post it today in Facebook too, because this is exactly what I do when I don't want to use Photoshop and I want to do it faster. Look, it's totally amazing, before and after. I hope you liked the video. If you did, please like the video, comment it, and stay connected with me, join my channel and share in my channel. Thank you so much. I hope to meet some of you during my workshop during the year. We will do many stronger things and stronger post-processing. I will give you exactly my workflow about the post-processing in Photoshop. This is totally amazing. If you like this one, the other one is wow, it's a wow. So I'm very excited. See you the next week, and bye bye.